Hi friends, in this session we will discuss two examples of how to construct Mohr emission. Suppose the first example is construct Mohr emission for output is A. Whenever the sequence 01 is encountered, that means for first example, if inputs are 0, 1, according to the problem, if inputs are 0, 1, outputs, that is delta output, is equal to A, comma. Input symbols 01 and output symbols are A, comma B. Whenever a sequence 01 is encountered, or whenever a sequence 01 occurs in the finite automata, it produces an output of A. That means otherwise, if 01 is not encountered, the output as B. So first thing is construct DFA that satisfies this condition. After construction of DFA, write the outputs. So our concept is the construct DFA that the sequence 01 has to be occurred. So assume initial state Q0 0, it moves to some state Q1 on 1, it moves to some state Q2. There are no final states in Mohr and Mill emission. So the substring 01 is accepted. So our concept is to construct DFA. DFA means from every state we have both the inputs. So Q0 on 0 is completed. Now Q0 on 1. Substring is 01 means, so before 0 we have any number of 1s. Before this part 01 we have any number of 1s. So no problem. Suppose Q0 on 0 is completed, Q0 on 1 is completed. Next to Q1 on 0. Suppose if starts from 0, 1, again 0. Suppose if the string is 0, 0, 1. So the substring 0, 1 is accepted. So this is fine. For example, if the string is 0, 1, what about Q2? For example, if Q2 on 0, if Q2 on 0, it forms the string 1, 0. It leads to problem. Compulsory we have a string that ends with 0, 1. For that purpose, suppose 0, 1, again 0 and 1. So the substring 0, 1 is compulsory encountered. 0, 1, 0, 1, substring encountered. For example, output of Q2 is 1. Input for Q2 is 1. It moves to this position. This is normal DFA. So this is not a Mohr emission. So according to the condition, to make the substring 01, we are constructing DFA. After construction of DFA, construct Mohr emission. So the Mohr emission concept is output is A whenever 01 is encountered. First to fix that one. Initially we start at Q0. If input is 0, Q0 on 0, so it does not form the substring. Our substring is 01. Q0 on 0 does not form the substring. Suppose moves to Q1. Q1 on 1 moves to Q2, so it forms the substring. 0, 1 and finally reach to state Q2. Whenever the sequence 01 occurred at state Q2. 01 occur at state Q2. Further state the output is A. In remaining all cases, the default the output is B. This is the Mohr emission. So first to construct DFA for the given problem. Once DFA is constructed, check the case. The case is whenever the sequence 01 occurred, it prints the output. For example, consider any string 1011010. Suppose consider this string. Initially we are at state Q0. Q0 on input 1. We are moving to Q0. Output as B. Q0 on input 0. We are moving to Q1. Output as Q1 output is B. Q1 on input 1. We are moving to Q2. Output as A. So observe, whenever the sequence 01 occurs, it produces output A. Suppose Q2 on input 1, it moves to Q0, output as B. Q0 on 0 moves to Q1, output of Q1 is B. Q1 on 1 moves to Q2, output of Q2 is A. Observe, the sequence 01 occurs, it produces the output A. So it satisfies the given problem. This is the Moore machine for the given. Next, count the occurrences of the substring BAA. Count the occurrences of the substring BAA. Suppose for the second question, assume sigma is equal to inputs alphabets are A comma B, delta is equal to 0 comma 1. Whenever if BAA occurs, it produces output as 1. In remaining all cases, it produces output as 0. Now, first to construct DFA, Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. First to satisfy the minimum condition is BAA. BAA. So BAA is completed. To form the remaining terms, so the substring is BAA. Substring is BAA. Now Q0 on input A. Substring is BAA. Before BAA, we have any number of A's, no problem. Suppose Q1 on A goes to this one. Q1 on B. So no problem. Again, it forms the substring BAA. Forms the substring BAA. Suppose Q2. Q2 on A, no problem. Q2 on B. Suppose it forms like this. BAA. Forms like this. Q3. Suppose Q3 on A. Q3 on A moves to Q0. It forms BAA. For example, Q3 on B. Assume Q3 on B moves to this one. It forms BAA. This is the finite automata. This is deterministic finite automata for the substring BAA. Now our goal is, whenever BAA occurs, whenever BAA occurs, it produces output as 1. So BAA occurs at state 1. BAA occurs at state 1. That means remaining all cases, the output as 0. The output as 0. So it is very easy to construct Moore machine if construction of DFA is well known. So in the next session, we will discuss some more examples of how to construct Moore machine. Thank you.